Hey guys, Dave Norona here, and welcome to the 2015 Ski-Doo sled season. I've got the brand new Summit X with T3 package, and I'm gonna take you through the top 10 things I do before this thing ever hits the snow. These are just my opinions, so you can do your own thing and make your sled your own, but these are the things I do. Let's get started. All right, number one, we're gonna talk about something that's special to the T3 package, and that's this brand new DS3 ski. It comes a little bit narrower up front, as well as a deeper keel, and that's to help in those conditions when it's not super deep, so it'll carve and side hill easier. I live in BC, so we get lots of deep pow, and we have this slip-on that just slips on over the ski. With two bolts, it's attached, and you're good for the pow. Take it off. Very, very cool, and the first time we've had a tunable ski. The second thing that I'm gonna do is I add a skid plate. I prefer the extreme skid plate because it's nice and narrow, it doesn't hold snow, but it protects the underbelly of the XM perfectly. And number three is the grill kit to keep all that deep pow that I love to get out of my engine compartment. Summit X with T3 package now comes with scratchers, and you wanna run these. It's gonna keep your sliders as well as your sled running cool. If you're running an in-season Summit or a Summit X, you're gonna wanna grab some of these scratchers out of the catalog and throw them on your skid. Well, Carl Kuster would kill me if I didn't mention number five, and that's to get the riser in line with the steering post. It'll help you carve and side hill even better than before. You're welcome, Carl. Well, number six is the link system. Your sled comes pre-drilled, so all you have to do is add the link attachments and then slide your gas can right in. Or if you want to change out a gas can and run a bag, it's the same thing. All right, number seven, we're going to take you through a little bit of the clutch side area. First of all is your CVT. I know for those in the past, if you've come from a Rev or an XP, you haven't had the CVT. Make sure you don't drill it out, leave it on. It holds your spare belt and your tools, and although it looks like it would hold temperatures in, it's designed so that it evacuates the heat right out of the left footwell. It also has this very cool goggle holder that you can put, and I got a flash pair of goggles in there ready to go if my other ones fog up. We're gonna talk a little bit about adjusting your clutches for elevation. They'll usually come from a dealer set up at either 3 or 4, most likely 3. With this TRA clutch, you can actually adjust the clickers on it to adjust for elevation or making sure that you hit the RPM of 7,900. Wouldn't worry about it too much during the break-in, but once your sled is broken in, then you can, after you're riding all day, look on hills. If you're hitting about 7,500 RPM and it's not going any higher, you can move those clickers, if they're at 3, up to 4. The thing that you want to make sure is that you put all the clickers on the same number. Very easy to do. And one tip is to don't back up the bolts and take the nuts off. There's an important washer in there. And next thing we're gonna talk about is changing your belt. This is very easy to do. You take the belt tool, screw it in. This is gonna pull the secondary sheaves apart, and you're gonna be able to take the belt off. There is a direction on the belt, so make sure it goes on the same way you took it off, and then you can put your belt on. One final tip when we're talking about the clutch area is you wanna keep it clean. Some people never go in here and there's clutch dust and rubber over everything. How to make your belts last and your clutches clean for a long time to give you the best performance. Keep this area nice and clean. I use brake cleaner so it doesn't leave a residue and it gets rid of all the crap. And every 5 to 8 rides, I take my belt off, take it and wash it with sunlight detergent, clean it up, dry it off, put it back in, and you're good to go. Well, number eight is electric start. That's right, I know people might call me a wimp, but in a day you can start your sled anywhere from 20 to 40 times, and if you're sled skiing, that number goes to 60 to 80 times. It makes a huge difference and you save a ton of energy by running electric start. I use the EarthX lithium battery because it's super lightweight. It also has a battery management system. It's also not a gel, it's a powder, so it's good to minus 30. That battery management system also means it won't over-discharge or overcharge, and you don't need a special charger to charge it. You just throw it in and go, and that's what I like. It also saves 11.5 pounds, so you're literally getting electric start for about 9 pounds, and that's good value. And before we close the door, don't forget to top your oil up with only the best XPS 2-stroke synthetic. Number Number nine is a new product that I'm going to be running this year, and it's called the Phantom Air. As you can see, it's got this cord here that actually recognizes your hand, and you set it for the RPM. So in the instance, if your sled was started with a full open throttle, if it was iced up, it actually would stop the sled right away. If your hand moves away from it, it actually shuts the sled off. And one cool feature of this, if your sled flips over, it also will shut off in a rollover. Very cool, and look for more information on this as we move through the season, and I'll let you know how it works. My final in the top 10 is to make sure you protect your investment with one of these awesome Skidoo wrap clip covers. They work amazing, they're easy to put on and take off. There's just one buckle at each front under the spindle, and then you pull them tight over the tunnel. Very easy to put on and off, and you don't get dirty. That's my top 10. Like I said, opinions vary, and you'll do different things to your sled, and that's what it makes your very own. The number one thing is to get out and have fun. That's what this sport's all about, and that's why the engineers make these sleds for us to have a great time. We'll see you out there. You can, of course, check all these things out in the Ski-Doo catalog or online, and of course, visiting your local dealer. Now get out there and get some pow.